woke up today with all butterflies in my stomach, all excited about how the day is going to go by and if things are going to fall straight and going to fall in place. And I was excited and waiting to see Alex. It's been like 1 week since I've not seen him. So I'm waiting to talk to him. And you know, so we started dated in 2006, and we first saw each other at St. Michael Church at Mahim. We had gone for a Naveena there, and I'd gone with my cousin. So she played Cupid actually, and he offered to drop us back home, and he acted like a gentleman, and then we exchanged numbers. And for 1.5 months, we used to only speak. I used to call him on from the landline, and we used to talk for hours and hours. And then one day I felt that, you know, I think I have some feelings for this guy. So I happened to ask him, like, will we go out or are you okay to date me? So he said, you know, I've never had a girlfriend before, so I don't know how it feels to have a girlfriend. So he said that, you know, I don't know, I'll give me some time to think. That's what he said. I mean, it's always the girl's answer. And then he said, okay. After like 24 hours, I think the first time he took me like at bandstand, it was raining and pouring, and it was like we were drenched. So he's very humble, very down to earth, very kind, and always ready to help. He's been there always for me. And when we were apart like for like 3 months, things didn't work out. So it was like it was always that when Alex is near, everything worked out really well for me. So it same thing for him. He calls me his lucky charm. And I know he loves me a lot. And he says, I don't love him at all. But no, that's not true. Hi, baby. The day has finally arrived after 10 years. We are doing this finally. And waiting to see you. And I promise that you'll always have a say in the relationship. I really promise. I really love you. I'm sorry for anything wrong that I did or said or hurt you ever.
There are no words to paint a picture of you, girl. Your eyes and those curves, it's like you're from some other world. You walk in my way, oh God, it's so frustrating. So why do I disappear when you come near? It makes me feel so small. Why do I blow my lines most every time? Like I've got no chance at all. If I could be a Superman, I'd fly up to the stars and back again. Cause every time you touch my hand, you feel my powers running through your veins. But I can only write this song and tell you that I'm not that strong. Cause I'm no Superman. I hope you like me as I am. Now it ain't no lie, I have to tell you how I feel. But each time that I try, it gets a little more unreal. You say my name, oh God, I can't stop shaking. So why do I disappear when you come near? It makes me feel so small. If I could read your mind, girl, would I find any trace of me at all? If I could be a Superman, I'd fly into the stars and back again. Cause every time you touch my hand, you feel my powers burning through your veins. But I can only write this song and tell you that I'm not that strong. Cause I'm no Superman. I hope you like me as I am. La 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 la.
We met 10 years back, and Ellie proposed me. We met her at St. Michael's Church. We just met for Navina. So God was playing in His own way. Well, my parents have been chilled out right from the beginning, and they really liked her. They really loved her, and yeah, it's just her love. I really love her, and yeah, she also does that. I think more than me, she loves. I think she loves me the most. Our smiles, if you see most of our pictures together, we almost smile alike. We have a same taste of travel, and we love a bike. Yeah, we love to travel. The whole preparation was done by Ellie. So the color of my shoes, color of my coat, best man's, everything has been taken care of her. The whole idea is her. She's the mastermind. I've just followed her decisions, because I know she, whatever she does is right, and that's how it's been for the last 10 years. Ellie is someone who loves the people who are close to her. She has a friendly nature. Even after being an introvert, she quickly gels in with people. That's the best part of her. She just loves me. Ella, we're finally getting married, and this is the most happiest day of my life. I love you.
Some kind of magic happens late at night when the moon smiles down at me and bathes me in its light. I fell asleep beneath you in the tall blades of grass. Was new. I never had to ask. It's a brand new day. The sun is shining. It's a brand new day. For the first time in such a long, long time, I know save the best part for last. And most stories have a hero who finds you make your past. Yeah, you make your past. It's a brand new day. The sun is shining. It's a brand new day. For the first time in such a long, long time, I know I'll be okay.
forever could never be long enough for me. I feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. Say you will. Together could never be close enough for me to feel like I am close enough to you. You wear white and I wear out the words I love you, and you're beautiful. That the wait is over, love has finally showed her my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. Say you will.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear friends, you have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's ministers and this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now He enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Alex and Alicia, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes, I have.
Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
Yes, I will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church?
Yes, I will.
Yes, I will.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands and declare your consent before God.
I, Alex, take you, Alicia, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
I, Alicia, take you, Alex, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love and honor you the rest of my life.
You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in His goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with His blessings. What God has joined, men must not divide. Amen.
Alicia, take this ring as my son as a sign of my love and fidelity in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Holy Father, Creator of the universe, Maker of man and woman in your own likeness, source of blessing for married life, we humbly pray to you for this woman who today is united with her husband in this sacrament of marriage. May your fullest blessing come upon her and her husband, so that they may together rejoice in your gift of married love and enrich your church with their children. Lord, may they both praise you when they are happy, turn to you in their sorrows. May they be glad that you help them in their work and know that you are with them in their need. May they pray to you in the community of the church and be your witnesses in the world. May they reach old age in the company of their friends and come at last to the kingdom of heaven. We ask this to Christ our Lord.
Dear Lord, thank you for the sacrament of marriage that you've given us. Thank you for guiding us to where we are today. Teach us to love you as you love us. Help us to reach out to each other in grace so nothing will ever divide us.
May the Lord Jesus, who graced the marriage at Cana by his presence, bless you and your loved ones. Amen. May he who loved the church to the end unceasingly pour his love into our hearts. Amen. May the Lord grant that, bearing witness to faith in his resurrection, you may await with joy the blessed hope to come. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you all in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
I've been waiting for this moment for so long. An answered prayer, I know you are the one. I give to you my heart and soul with a love that will never grow old. In my life, I can see that you were made for me. You'll be there to catch me if I fall. All the days I have prayed and the love that I have saved, with this ring I'm giving you my all. I thank God for the gift he's given me, a love that's strong for all eternity. I give to you all of my days with the love for all of your ways. In my life I can see that you were made for me. I'll be there to catch you if you fall. All the days I have prayed and the love that I have saved, with this ring I'm giving you my. Thank you.
Alicia, entourage and family. Can we have you on the dance floor, please, everybody? Come on. Please, that's for the groom and the bride when they share a slice of cake. Universal protocol and traditional stuff right now. Well done, both of you. Okay, in fact, I was told that there are two guys doing it, but if one is already knocked off now, we have to decide between the two. Is it a toss? Is it a toss now? Bride's brother, Alvin. Yes, Alvin. Okay, that was Alvin finally. Arthur, childhood friend of the groom. And of course, Alvin, you all know, brother of the bride, based in the United Kingdom, working at Hyatt. What is a good saying about friendship?
You know that dirty secrets.
What is that? Come back.
You know their dirty secrets.
Aha. See who's speaking. And welcome Karishma Lobo, working for a reputed firm in Mumbai as the team head and tonight part of the entourage.
Come on, Karishma.
Okay, Ellie has very, very strictly told me to not wash any dirty laundry this evening and to keep everything to myself. So anybody who wants to know anything from the inside, please do meet me. I'm sitting at the table right there. So after mass, this little girl comes up to me and she tells me that, just look at the lady in white. Doesn't she look like a princess? And I was like, she couldn't have been any more right because she found her prince charming. If somebody had to tell this to me 10 years ago, I'd absolutely shake the life out of them and tell them it's pure bullshit. There's no such thing as a fairy tale. But I met Ellie, I met Alex 10 years ago, and I knew them each equally well. And you could look at them and on the first sight you would say that, you know, this is no puppy love. This is no teenage love story that is going to fade out in a couple of years. And today, standing here watching them with the rings on, it's amazing. It's really amazing because hats off to Alex. He can really, really bear this girl. So when they initially started dating, okay, 10 years ago, and auntie, this is what they were doing behind your back. They never told you all this. So that is when Alex had told her that, listen, I'm not going to promise you the sun and the moon, and I'm not going to promise you stars, and it's not going to be all roses. And she said, okay. Ideally, I mean, I don't know, if it were me, I would have been like, dude, I want the moon right now. But she said, okay. And ever since then, Alex has done everything in his power and in his will to go ahead and make this woman happy. And vice versa, she's taken care of him. She's always been there for him. She's been his spine through everything, to thick and thin. And I don't think they could have found anybody better, because if they say matches are made in heaven, this is your clear example for it. So here's to Ellie, Alex, and forever, and the happily ever after. Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you very much.
All right, so I would say 90% what Karishma said was right. And
She's crying.
I had tears in my eyes when she was saying some things. So yes, she's right, but at the same time, this one is a very beautiful girl. Beautiful at heart, beautiful from outside as well. Thank you for everyone coming here. I really love you all, and I really appreciate from every places that you're coming here to attend this, you know, this special day for us. And I think the beautiful words are the last words should be said by Ellie. I don't have any right on that, right? So, yeah, Ellie, go ahead.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming from so far, everyone. From, you know, it shows how special we are to y'all. And thank you, Karishma, for the nice words.
I'm here for the food.
Thank you, Mommy, Daddy, for everything. Thank you, Elvin and Nelina, for everything that you have done for us. Thank you. Now I'm your daughter. Okay. Thank you. Only person I'm missing here today is my auntie, Lassie. She's not here. She's been like my second mom. And I really wish she was here today. Thank you, everyone. Please enjoy the evening. Thank you for coming from so far. Thank you. Cheers to you all.
Cheers.
Ladies and gentlemen, A26 with a wedding march. Let's celebrate. Let's participate. Let's make it special for the bride.
Very good. That's the spirit.
Ellie, bless them, Ellie. Ah, give them blessings.
People record our tune, the dance. everybody. The first place, I'm really scared to stand in front of all of you all. But anyway, I'm going to do it. You are safe. You are safe with me. And you are welcome to come to my country. Everybody says it's frightening. It's not at all. It's a lovely country. Believe me. Don't say that. Anyway, this is a wedding dinner blessing. I had to write it down because I got a little nervous. Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you for the food we share tonight to celebrate Alicia and Alex's marriage. We thank you for the love and guidance, support of their parents, families, and friends. We thank you for making this day an enjoyable and blessed one for those who worked hard to make this day a real success for Alex and Alicia. For this prayer in Jesus Christ our Lord, let us now join and say the grace before meals. Bless us, O Lord, and these thy gifts, which we are about to receive from thy bounty, to Christ our Lord. Amen.
Okay. Thank you. You get the string, not the bouquet.
Okay.
Okay, keep that as a souvenir. One by one.
Cut.
Okay, yeah.
Only three are left. This is done or what?
Take hold. 1 second,
hold still. Take it on top.
Cut.
Only two are left. Left side, left side.
Now. Stop pulling.
Okay. Cut it.
Yes, she passed it.
So she's the winner.
Okay.
One more is left. Yeah, one more you have to cut it.
One more.
Done.
Yes, that's for you. Let's do the garden.
Go, Alex!
Benji! Yes! Yeah, that's